Hey guys, welcome to Gaming here. I'm here to play some Dying Light, and I... well... just gotta wait for it to load. Yeah, I know about that.
I spoke with Brecken. He's depressed and wants to go talk to Rice himself. Except that'll only get him killed. Maybe I can help out.
Wait.
Yeah, I'm with you.
Great. Look for me in one of the boxcars on the train transport near the school.
Okay. And listen, Jade. If we don't find that Antizin, I'll need to talk to you about something.
About what?
Another option, but we'll cross that bridge when we come to it. Right now, let's see what we can find in that school.
Jade
knows where we might be able to get more answers in. I'm supposed to meet her in one of the boxcars near the school. What's on your mind?
Mr. Crane, are you familiar with a man named Vulcan Duff?
Vulcan Duff? I didn't know he was still...
Hi, dude.
This is Crane. Can you hear me on this thing?
Yeah, who is this?
This is Dogger.
And Satine?
Work for Mr. Dahl, and we are ready to put you to task. Get here on the double. Make it quick.
Hey, that's rude. Don't touch him like that.
Shut up, Fantine. Get off the radio.
You're going to make him mad, you idiot.
Stop talking, or I will punch you.
Punch me? I'll kill you.
Idiosyncratic, great.
Open.
Yeah. inside.
Huh.
saw Tahir at the school. He and his men were hauling all kinds of stuff out of there. Okay, Jade, I'm inside.
Check the classrooms. That's the most likely place for them to store supplies. They should be marked somehow. Military jargon is pretty straightforward, so it shouldn't be hard to spot. Somebody in here that don't need to be here. Find out that gun. Oh, for fuck's sake, Crane! Turn the right in there.
In the sky, gazing far into the night, I raise my hand to the fire, but it's no use, cause you can't stop it from shining through.
Shit, James, I went looking for Angus and then found explosives instead. Now we need to get the hell out of here before Tigger comes
back. If you believe it's true, baby, won't you let the light shine through for you?
Hey, you want to try calming down long enough? What do you? Oh, I'm sorry. Maybe,
look, half of this. It seems fair.
Charged. that I can do for you?
I believe I can provide some context. You may find it useful. You may not.
Okay, lay it on me.
I did not witness this firsthand, so take it as hearsay if you want. But it involves his brother Hassan.
I know about Hassan. He died, right? And Rice blames the GRE.
He is right, too. Hassan was confined to a wheelchair, and he was the only person in the world Rice cared about. Hassan acted as a tempering influence on his brother. When Rice went to war, Hassan convinced him to seek peace. And when the outbreak happened, Rice demanded that the GRE evacuate Hassan first and foremost.
And they didn't. With the GRE, you're saying he's justified?
I do not excuse him. He's a vicious gangster. I like his voice. I merely wanted to help you understand the enemy more surely.
Understood. Thanks.
Alright, that's going to be it for this episode. Thank you very much for watching. Please leave a like, subscribe. And bye for now.